Hello friends, so today we are in a very unique conversation with three handsome young gentlemen, and that's including me as well. So we are reviewing a project by Ambience, and this is called Ambience Tiverton, a super luxury apartment at Sector 50 Noida. In conversation with me, I have a dynamic and young and handsome dynamic person, Shashank Jain from Wudufa Interiors. And Shashank, would you like to introduce yourself?
Thank you. Hi guys, this is Shashank Jain from Wudufa Interiors. We're a luxury architectural and interior firm located in Noida. Happy to help.
Also with me in conversation is Saurabh Maulik. And Saurabh is AGM sales for luxury residential apartments with Ambience. Saurabh, would you like to say hello to your gentleman?
Hello everyone, I'm Saurabh Maulik. I'm taking care of this luxury condominium apartments by Ambience. And we'll be discussing few more topics regarding the luxury sales, regarding the apartments. Though we have some experts on board, from channel is Tarun, from our expert advisor on architects and visions from Shashank. Definitely we'll have some great talks.
Thank you. Looking forward.
And I am your host and those, Tarun Jain from Earth Matters Realty. I'm the principal advisor and founder of this company. And it's a research-driven advisory and transaction company for properties. And we help you to make right decisions so that you don't go wrong at a later date and regret about any property investments. So starting, let's start without wasting any time. Let me ask you, Saurabh, we would like to know, because since we are talking about Ambience and we are reviewing this particular property, I would want you to give us a brief background about Ambience as a group.
Okay, so Ambience as a group, we started our journey more than three decades back by building developer flows in South Delhi. Then slowly and gradually, we diversified our business into hospitality, into education, into commercials, and into then again residential condominium apartments. So we have iconic developments like Vasant Kunj Mall. Then we also have 5-star hospitality delivery by Leela Ambience. Then we also have a state-of-the-art kind of an educational setup by Ambience Public School. Then again, we also are into corporate office spaces in Gurgaon and all. So majorly our forte lies in luxury. Be it be your apartment, be it be our hotels, be it be our malls, right?
Yeah. So I know that Ambience is a name which I think everyone reckons with luxury. Yeah. And I'm sure it's a no-brainer for people. I'm sure people who are seeing, they've seen Ambience malls and the Leela Hotel, which of course is a penultimate in luxury. So I believe that Ambience as a group has also delivered luxury projects like the Ambience Catriona, which is one of the most expensive apartments in Gurgaon, and the Ambience Island, etc. But we are talking of this project called Ambience Tiverton at Sector 50 Noida. Why did Ambience choose, and this apparently is the first project from Ambience in Noida.
Yeah.
What made Ambience choose this location?
Okay. Now Tarun, when we talk about luxury, it's not only related to the apartments, the quality that we put in, and not restricted to the society that we are delivering or we are constructing. Then again, with the location, right? So if you talk, when we talk about Noida, we have few locations which we actually call a luxury sectors where people like to live. Jo kisi ke liye ek address hai, ek habitation hai, jahan pe you'll have a club class living, up class gentry altogether, right? And Sector 50 is few of those sectors जहाँ पे हम ये सब एक्सपीरियंस कर सकते हैं इन टर्म्स ऑफ देयर डेंसिटी, इन टर्म्स ऑफ देयर लोकल हैबिटेशंस एंड ऑल. सो वी चोज दिस सेक्टर जस्ट बिकॉज देर इज इट्स एज पर अथॉरिटी सर मिड डेंसिटी जोन. सो देर आर न्यूमरस ह्यूमंगस लार्ज पार्क्स, ग्रीन एरियाज आर देयर. यू कैन सी द टोपोलॉजी इज एंटायरली ग्रीन. यू कैन सी इफ यू गो इन टू आर अपर फ्लोर्स इन आटास, यू विल सी एंटायर नोएडा इज विजिबल फ्रॉम दैट एरिया. So that is the reason we chose Sector 50 for our project, because for us luxury is not only into construction and putting up the quality inside the apartment, but then again the periphery of the sector in which it's there.
Yes, very well said, because I certainly believe you said it right, that luxury is not just within the apartment, but it is also outside of the apartment. And Sector 50 is one of the premium sectors of Noida. In fact, in Noida, we can just consider maybe 3 or 4 sectors which are very, very premium, starting from Sector 15A, 44, 47 and 50. These are predominantly the 4 sectors, and Sector 36 and 39 as well. But I think from the perspective of location, yes, this falls under the golden triangle, which I'm going to be explaining to the viewers in a later in the later part of this conversation. So yes, coming on to you, Shashank, today you had a great tour of this particular property. I think you saw this for the first time.
Yes.
And what's your take on this particular property as a from a designer's perspective, and how would you rate it? So, what's your take on this first and foremost?
Thank you, Tarun, for the question. Guys, I must say, this is the first time I came to this society and this luxury apartment complex. And the moment I saw the gate, they had put in their legacy board, and it really gave me that positive intent, that which means that the group is positive, that they are trying to deliver, unlike other developers or other people in the country, they're trying to say, okay, what this is what we have done and this is what we're looking at. So that was the first positive thought I had while entering into the society. And then when I entered into the club, then I saw that big hall and then the restaurant. So everything is very well connected. So generally, a lot of designers, a lot of architects, what they do is they misplace those elements. So either one element is too distant from other, or it is not at the center. The good part of their club and the banquet was that it is very well connected. The entire lobby is pretty big. So even if there is a big function happening within the society, this particular club can be used really well. And then the moment you exit the club, then we move to the landscaping area and we move to the pool. The good part of the pool was the e-pay. The flooring they've used, it was on a higher level. The sections were about 24 inches up, which is a really good thought, whosoever gave it. And then there were 2 or 3 kind of pools there within that same space. So these are small intricate details which have been thought through, and this cannot be done without the developer's intent. If the CMD or the developer or the people who's looking after the project is not having that intent of giving that luxury, you cannot have it. And trust me guys, I've been to various properties across Delhi NCR. I was in London for a while, I've been to their properties also. So what I felt was, yes, this is a luxury apartment I'm looking in. And then slowly when I was traveling through the society, I went to the tower A, I went to the tower C, and then we finally went to the actual apartment also. The second best thing was the staircase. Tarun, I've been to so many societies, every developer guy try to hinge on some space in the staircase. Either they try to intermingle lot many things together, or maybe have a fire exit space. What these guys have done, Sara, I must say, there was a commendable job by your team, by your design team, or by your operations team, that there was 2 different cases. So one was the staircase and one was the fire exit. And I have not seen many properties.
Well, I would say, Shashank, that's a mandatory requirement for any condominium society. It's a mandatory requirement. But I would actually like to draw draw your attention to the finer nitty-gritties of the luxury that we would want to talk about. What did you observe?
Absolutely. So when we talk about, Tarun, you very well said, when you talk about the luxury, we talk about luxury not just the inside the apartment. I always believe in luxury outside the apartment also. So for example, if you spend a crore rupee even on your apartment, but the lobby is not that great, even the staircase is not that great, or the landscaping is not that great, that 1 crore rupee on interiors, on design, is also a waste.
Absolutely.
So that will not help.
Absolutely.
So when we talk about the apartment, so the good part is, like the floor, they have a 3 BHK and a 4 BHK, and only 2 apartments are there with each servant. That itself gives you that feel, okay, this floor is mine.
Yeah.
It's a very private space, and not too many people will be traveling in and out of that particular lobby. And then let's go into the apartment. So when I say a 3 BHK apartment, what they've done good is they've given a powder room there. So not many builders or developers are looking into the powder room concept. And then the rooms, or the living room or the dining room. Let me give you strict details about the living and the dining space. So this was a pretty rectangular space, guys, for all the viewers on my channel, on Tarun's channel. So it is a rectangular space, and it is very less in a lot of builders' apartments, where the space is pretty big, where if you want to have a small party, you can definitely call out your chairs, your dining chairs, or maybe your crown chairs, or maybe your poofies, and the entire sofa seat arrangement becomes really nice. So if you want to have 3+2 or even have 4+2, it is very well possible here, because the back wall is pretty big. Since the back wall is big, then you have a lot of opportunity in design. So I never say apartment is 100% okay. I will say every apartment or every builder or every space will have 5-10% improvement chances. But if you're able to use that 90% of the space, I would say the apartment is really good to buy.
Yes.
And when I say living room and dining, I always say this is your heart of the apartment or your house or your dream home, guys. And if this is done really well as a designer or as a design element, then your entire apartment is super. Nobody goes to your master bedroom directly. Nobody goes to your kids' room directly. What they do is they come to your living room. They like to spend some time there. If you're happy there, I'm sure you're happy in the entire house.
Sure.
So then right. I would like to review their kitchen. So in both the apartment, the 3BHK and the 4BHK, they had parallel kitchens and a utility door. The good part was the door. Because even if you have a very big space in the kitchen, we live in India, right? We have maids. We have a lot of people traveling into our space. And you can have a wet area outside the kitchen. You can have a dry area inside the kitchen. They have very well given that space for the washing area, the utility area, or the wet double bowl sink can be provided in outside utility of the balcony. And then this balcony is located and strategically connected to a bedroom. This is really nice. So sometimes we don't want people to travel to the entire space, especially our servants, our maids. We don't want them to come to every part of the house. But what they can do is, like, they can go to the kitchen and then directly go to a bedroom or whatsoever is the second bedroom.
Correct.
Or the guest bedroom.
Correct.
It is.
Correct.
And it's that small nitty-gritties, like, as a designer, I always like to deploy my mind into it. Because this is how, for a builder, it does not really matter, right? Why will they give an extra door? It will cost them. But the thought is, they're trying to give a better luxury to their users, their buyers. And that's a real nice thought. And okay. Second important thing which I really liked, Tarun, is...
I think Shashank is really excited about seeing the project today. And
that's a good thing for us. In fact, that is why we asked an expert to be on board and give their own expert comments and
yes.
thought process. Because what we used to do is, being a sales guy, being a channel, being a client, we have that naked eye, right? So we have that kind of approach jahan pe hame cheez bluntly badi lagti hai, choti lagti hai. लेकिन उस पे पीछे क्या एक्सपर्टीज रहती है, क्या ऑब्जर्वेशंस रहते हैं. तो थैंक यू सो मच सचान फॉर बीइंग सच अ हंबल एंड ऑनेस्ट गाय.
थैंक यू.
मैं मानता हूं जो भी आप कह रहे हो वो ऑनेस्टली कह रहे हैं.
100% ऑनेस्टली कहता हूं गाइस. और मैंने कुछ स्क्रिप्ट नहीं किया. मुझे सर हमने कोई पैसे नहीं दिए. मुझे तो हमने कोई पैसे नहीं दिए. ये सब कुछ वाकई में जेन्युइनली आई एम कमिंग इट आउट ऑफ माय हार्ट. इफ यू गाइस हैव सीन माय चैनल वुडोफा, तो आप देखते हैं मैं ऑलरेडी इतने सारे वीडियोस बनाता हूं. आई नेवर से एनी फॉल्स स्टेटमेंट्स देयर. Because I believe as a value to the customer, it is very important that you say truth.
True.
Yeah.
So और मुझे कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ता है एम्बियंस मेरे बारे में क्या सोचता है या जो लोग हैं वो क्या सोच रहे हैं. मुझे लगता है कि मेरी वैल्यू तब अच्छी है जब मैं आपकी अच्छी वैल्यू दे पाऊँ.
Correct.
That is how customer you can win the trust of the customer.
Of the customer.
And that Correct. Is the need of the right.
Correct. Correct. Then अभी मैं वही बोलने वाला था कि जैसे बेडरूम में इन बोथ टू ऑफ द बेडरूम्स आई saw, I think in the front bedroom and in the second bedroom, they've given secret wardrobes. Generally, as a builder, they would have covered it. But उन्होंने wardrobe बनाने का space दिया. छोटा सा space है भले ही वहाँ पर decor आ सकता है, भले ही वहाँ पर एक wardrobe आ सकती है छोटी, but it is an extra space which nobody will think about.
Correct.
And then every room they've given two kind of wardrobes. So guys, ये बहुत important है. So every house there is a man and there is a woman, right? So and हम लोगों की भैया बहुत छोटी वार्डरोब होती है, जनरली लड़कियों की ज्यादा बड़ी वार्डरोब होती है. और ये सब कुछ एम्बियंस ने ऑलरेडी केटर कर लिया.
करेक्ट करेक्ट करेक्ट.
दे गिवन टू स्पेसेस इन बोथ द बेडरूम्स, वन फॉर अ मेन वार्डरोब एंड वन फॉर अ वुमेन वार्डरोब. दिस इज रियली नाइस. बिकॉज़ भले आप वहां पर वार्डरोब मत लगाओ तरुण, सौरभ, वहां पर एक स्टडी टेबल भी लगा सकते हो और मे बी एन एक्स्ट्रा चेयर भी डाल सकते हो, बट दे हैव गिवन दैट स्पेस व्हिच इज नॉट लुकिंग ऑड,
या
व्हिच इज नॉट लुकिंग परपेचुअल, लाइक वो पर्ट्यूड नहीं कर रहा है बाहर, वो खराब नहीं लग रहा है,
करेक्ट,
वो अच्छा लग रहा है,
करेक्ट. So I think I would like to draw the attention of our viewers on further, because you know, as a realtor, from the realtor's perspective, what I feel as a luxury, which so to speak, people they look at. Of course, Shashank has, you know, as a designer, Shashank will always talk about the finer nitty gritties, which I'm sure you must have enjoyed listening to him. But from a realtor's perspective, let me tell you that, you know, the basics of luxury that people look at. I think people look at that if they are staying in an apartment, what's the kind of gentry that people are going to be staying with.
True.
So I think an important aspect is that a lot of times we see that, you know, people they have 2-bedroom apartments, 3-bedroom apartments, 2-bedroom with study and etc like that, and then people they talk about that as luxury apartment. Over here we've only got 2 apartments to a floor. We only have sizes which are big sizes, because we've got about a 2500 square feet, about close to about 2600 square feet as a 3-bedroom apartment, and close to about 3300 square feet as a 4-bedroom apartment. And then we've got penthouses which are about 4800 square feet and 6000 square feet. So truly the kind of gentry that we're going to be having, 2 apartments facing, 2 apartments to a court, that's something which is there. You've got the premium stuff that has been put on, being put by the developer. In fact, ambience ke liye thoda sa demeaning ho jayega if they kind of, you know, put substandard stuff. So I think ambience has not gone down or compromised on the quality of equipment or the fixtures and fittings. You observe that, I'm sure.
Just to add on to Tarun's point, so bathroom ki hum baat kare, so they've done really well, and the Italian marble. So generally I've seen developers, a lot of developers who Italian marble naam ke liye dal dete hain, it is generally Egyptian or maybe a lower class marble. Whereas what these guys have done, I'm not just boasting about them, but they've really put the Italian marble.
Yeah.
So unhone Dyna marble dala, Crema marble dala, Sicilia dala, and even the bathrooms. I mean, the bathrooms also have that Italian marble.
Sure.
And it's a real nice thing, because guys, agar aap log khud Italian marble lagane jaoge na bathroom mein, let me tell you, for an apartment of this size, it will cost you about 5 to 7 lakh rupees just to put that Italian marble.
Okay.
Polishing and other stuff is separate.
Great.
So they've done really good in spending that 8 to 10 lakh rupees money in an apartment to give that luxury.
All right. Okay. Sure. Thank you so much for that feedback point.
So Tarun, this is a reverse question to you. So you've been asking so many questions to both of us. Ab to meri bari hai.
Yeah.
So Tarun, my first question to you is, what do you see about the luxury in this particular project? And how do you see this is different than others?
Okay, so what I understand from your question is that how do I rate it as a luxury project in Noida.
Correct.
With regards to any other apartment complex or any other condominium? So very interesting question. Guys, it's actually difficult for me to really answer that particular question, because you know, in Noida, we have very, very limited luxury apartments over here. If I have to probably, you know, ask the gentleman over here, or probably ask the viewers, in asking them that on your fingertips, tell me 10 top luxury projects of Noida, probably you will be dumbfounded when you come to the number of 6 or 7, because you would not be able to find out.
True.
You'll not be able to really evaluate. So from that perspective, I say that, you know, if I have to talk about in sector 50, so luxury projects are pretty much spread across in Noida. In sector 50, if we have to really talk about, we have Ambience Tiverton as a project, which is a very good project. One very old project, which is still preferred by a lot of people, is Purvanchal Silver Estate. It's a low rise project, and nicely maintained. The developer is out and the RWA is managing that particular project. So these are the two projects which I would say that, you know, are pretty much there in sector 50. If you have to look at on the expressways, then there are a couple of projects like OMAX Forest Spa is there.
Okay.
Insect 107 people, they talk about Pratik edifice, but then of course not everyone balances it out, you know, some things up and down is always there. Then there are some under development projects, like Kalpatru is coming up with a project in golf course of JP Greens, and it's a great location with a great project product mix. However, something on the similar lines of what Ambience is, but that's a different segment altogether. That's on the expressway. And then Omax Forest Spa, which is again on the expressway. So I really can't think of too many ready projects. So this being a ready developed project wherein, you know, people will start to move in couple of months and we will see lights all around. So from that perspective, I would say that these are very many projects. These are some of the projects that I have, I could think about. Viewers, you may also participate in this discussion and maybe in the comments box put in what's your viewpoint on luxury apartments in Noida, and which is the one project that you would wish to consider, or you would actually rate it as luxury apartments. We would like to have your views too.
That's a very important statement Tarun made, Saurabh, that our viewers, if you go to different properties, you've been visiting so many properties all across Noida or Gurgaon whatsoever, you write what is luxury according to you.
True, because your reviews actually matters a lot to any other developer, because you are the end user, you are the buying person, you are the person who are spending money out of your pockets. So that is more important for us. In fact, और भी क्या डेवलपमेंट्स हम इस प्रोजेक्ट में कर सकते हैं या नेक्स्ट हमारा अपकमिंग प्रोजेक्ट में हम क्या क्या इसको इरेडिकेट या इसको हम हटा सकते हैं, दैट वी विल आल्सो ट्राई टू डू. बट देन अगेन योर रिव्यूज ऑन द कमेंट बॉक्स इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, सो दैट वी कैन एक्चुअली नो कि जो हमारा जो थॉट प्रोसेस है वो आप कितना कंसिडर कर रहे हैं.
करेक्ट. सो आई गेस दैट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड अ वैलिड सजेशन बाय द जेंटलमैन हियर. So
honestly Tarun, from the developer side, he's pretty honest about it. Ki acha kuch kami hai to bata do, agle project mein improve karenge.
For me, honesty is the best policy, and when I am catering to a client who is shedding out 2+ year, 4+ year amount, got an experience in the market, have a good hand on other properties as well, so it is more wiser to be honest than to be dumb in front of a customer.
Well, I think absolutely that's true, and you know, it flows down from the top.
Yes.
So the promoter and the chairman of this particular group, Mr. Raj Singh Gehlot, I think he's got one policy that I know of, and that is never compromise on anything. And that goes in, it actually goes about that we can see that in every project of Ambience. So yes, thank you so much for that.
Thank you so much for the answer, Tarun. It was great, I think. And my second question to Tarun is about the price point, Tarun, because I've been hearing a lot of information about the prices here in Ambience. What do you think, how their prices are being rated?
Correct. So I guess when we also talk about the price points and when we talk about the luxury projects, I would say that this particular property commands a price which apparently right now what it is there, it should have been much higher than that. So from that perspective, I feel that, you know, people who have invested into this particular project in these times, or you know, in the times that in the last about one and a half years or so, they've gotten a very value deal, because we are looking at a price point of about say anywhere between 9,000 to 10,000 rupees per square feet for a place like this, for a place in Sector 50. That's a property price which is, I would say that it's quite reasonable. I know for that for one thing, that Meghdootam at one point in time used to be traded at a price point of about 14,000 rupees to 15,000 rupees per square feet. Properties like JP Greens Augusta Town Homes have traded at a price point of about 18,000 to 19,000 rupees per square feet. Properties like Pearl Gateway Towers has gone to a price point of about 14,000 to 15,000 rupees a square feet. And these are the actual figures. So these are the figures. And if I'm talking about something like a price point of about 9,000 rupees a square feet, 9,500 rupees a square feet, for a development which is like a fully loaded apartment from all perspectives, people can actually review my other video which I have done for the Tiverton. So I would say that it's a value deal at that price point, and investments at this point in time are sure to be giving a return of somewhere close to about 50% plus in another maybe couple of years, maybe about a year and a half, when we actually see habitation coming in. And 270 odd apartments in about 4 acres of land parcel, I think it's nothing. So I see that
so
coming
that's
very soon.
A real good point, guys. And as a designer, I would like to suggest, yes, about a 4 acre plot and only 270 apartments is a pretty good size, because generally I've seen developers loading too many apartments there, and ultimately it becomes a rush.
Yeah.
And you don't feel like spending time in the clubs or maybe in the landscape areas, because there's always people around. So
and the reason keeping this at a this density or low density kind of a thing is the amenities that we are providing should be accessible to the residents, right? We don't want to overcrowd the entire thing. Ki hum restaurants there, double height banquets there, all those 5-star amenities are there. But then again, overcrowding se wo aap access nahi kar sakte. You cannot use that particular amenities. So there is no use. There is no point giving that. Right?
Sure. So great. I think pretty much detailed conversations that we have had. We would be very happy to receive your comments and questions, and we would be more than happy to answer those. One last goodbye note that you guys would want to say to our viewers.
So guys, as a designer, as presenting Woodofa, you've been watching our videos. I say this project is a yes. And I really like the entire ambience from Ambience, and what they've done is pretty good. I will say go for it.
Yes, thank you.
So it was a healthy exchange of conversation that we had. I only request you people just visit the property, have an experience of the luxury, come see what we have done, come see what we have put in the brand, the quality and the thought process of the developer. Come have an experience of the luxury in Sector 50. We have a beautiful 32 acres of Meghdootham Park just behind our project with a direct access from this project only. We have beautiful state of the art kind of a this clubhouse catering, all those restaurants, banquet, indoor activities and all. So just pay a visit, give us the opportunity to meet you in person and promote and explain the entire project to you.
Yeah, thank you so much. And one final key point from me is, guys, stay safe, be healthy. These are tough times, and watch out for the space. And for any other requirement of yours and for any other conversations or clarifications, we are always there. Talk to the experts.
Then again, I would like to thank Mr. Tarun and Mr. of course Shashank ji.
Thank you.
Being an expert of this this industry and taking out time and paying a good hefty amount of hours to this project, understand the nitty-gritties, every inch and corner, every brick and stone. And thank you so much, guys, for covering this up, and hopefully we'll be doing this again and again, because things are changing on a very greater pace on this project.
Sure.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, guys. And
guys.
See you later.
Take care.
Adios.
Enjoy. Bye.
Rajiv ji, thank you so much for coming. Viewers, we have with us Mr. Rajiv Dhal, who's the sales head of Ambience, and under his guidance and aegis, this project is being sold and marketed. So Rajiv ji, one question from you for our viewers. What is the one thing that you feel is important for our viewers and people wanting to look at this particular property? Kya aap unko ek message dena chahenge?
Thanks for asking this, Tarun. मैं आपको एक ही पॉइंट बताऊंगा जो मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट है फॉर दिस प्रोजेक्ट फॉर एंड यूजर क्लाइंट्स इन्वेस्टर्स और हमारे व्यूअर्स को वो है इस प्रोजेक्ट की लोकेशन जिस लोकेशन में ये प्रोजेक्ट है सेक्टर 50 ऑफ नोएडा ये प्रोजेक्ट जो है वो डेवलप्ड सेक्टर में है आपको नोएडा में आपने देखा होगा कुछ अंडर डेवलप्ड एरियाज हैं कुछ डेवलपिंग एरियाज हैं सेक्टर 50 इज फुली डेवलप्ड एरिया
यस
वन ऑफ द बेस्ट लोकेशन ऑफ द नोएडा
यस
दूसरी बात बोलूंगा मैं कि इस लोकेशन के साथ साथ एम्बियंस एज ए ब्रांड, एम्बियंस एड्रेस करता है लग्जरी को और लग्जरी का सिनोनिमस है,
नो डाउट अबाउट इट।
तो लग्जरी यदि आपको लेनी है तो एम्बियंस ट्रूली मैच करता है लग्जरी के साथ। तो दिस इज द टू पॉइंट्स जो मैं आपको बताऊंगा जिसके लिए ये प्रोजेक्ट।
वेरी वेल सेड सर। सो यस आई थिंक we also discussed this particular point that ambience is the name synonymous with luxury. So on that note, I would like to thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
We shall certainly wish you all the very best with this project, and I'm sure the happiness quotient in this apartment complex will be absolutely at the top level. Thank you so much, viewers, for watching this conversation with Rajiv ji. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.